والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. So, alhamdulillah, yesterday we spoke about Abdullah ibn Haram and his son Jabir radiallahu anhu. And subhanAllah, this amazing name of the Ansar, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, حُبُّ الْأَنصَارِ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ. Loving them is faith. Just love these people, it's just part of faith. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you know, it's only because I came from Mecca, I'm not Ansar. I wish I was, you know, from the Ansar, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Jabir radiallahu anhu, he was the only son left by his father to look after six girls. So his father, we said yesterday, told him, I feel like I'm going to be martyred tomorrow in the Battle of Uhud. You look after the children, you look after the girls. Subhanallah. So when Uhud started, yes, his father was martyred. And the Prophet ﷺ said to him, calming him down, he says, Allah did not speak to anyone, any human being, before your father directly like that. Allah spoke to your father, you know, kifahan, just directly. You can't even imagine, we don't want to say anything else. Can you imagine speaking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Subhanallah. So what did Allah say to him? He said to him, tamanna ya abdi, what do you wish for? And he says, I want to go back and be martyred again. Now he can see the honor, he can see the blessing, he can see. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, no. There's only one death. إِنَّهُمْ إِلَيْهَا لَا يُرْجَعُونَ. You don't go back to earth again. He says, oh Allah, deliver the message to my people. I want them to know what I am in. The ayah was revealed, and don't think that those who are martyred are dead. They are living. A life more perfect than this life, provided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. عند ربهم يرزقون. So Jabir radiallahu anhu, one journey with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is traveling, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, subhanallah, the king, the leader, the prophet, the imam, the elder, everything he has, the teacher, he will be weighing behind everybody else, right at the back. Why? Just to check if anybody is slow, anybody is sick, anybody is missing. Subhanallah. And he find some slow camels, you know, the behind, always slow, old, tired camels. And he says, who is that? And says, Jabir. Prophet ﷺ slowed down and wait for Jabir to come close to him, and they chatted and they traveled to Medina going back together. The Prophet ﷺ, one of the things he said to him, how is the family? How is the girls? He said, I got married. He says, MashaAllah, you got married? He says, yeah. So he said to him, Abikr, I'm Thayyib, a young one or old one? He said, I married an old one. I don't want another young one. I got six girls already. I don't want to marry another one that will play with them. I want someone to look after them. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam laughed and he joked with him. Then he said to him, what's wrong with your camel? It's a bit slow. Why are you behind? Why are you in the end? He said, this very poor. You know, I'm looking after all those girls, paying the debt of my father's. There's, you know, not much money to buy a strong camel. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam make dua for the camel and says to the camel, just move faster. And they say, we're struggling to slow this camel down. It was just going for it. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, said to him, okay, Jabir, a good camel now? He said, oh, very good camel now. He said to him, sell it to me. The Prophet said to him, sell it to me, how much? This camel was just dying a few hours ago. Now the Prophet ﷺ says, sell it to me. How much? So Jabir says, say example, 10 dinar. Okay, so when we arrive, yeah, not taking it now, when we arrive in Medina, I'll give you the money, you give me the camel. So they arrived in Medina, Jabir gone home to, you know, unload the luggage and stuff of travel, and he told his family, the Prophet ﷺ bought the camel. And they got really angry. You know, it's like the only car, and he sold the car. What are we going to, in old days, camel is everything. Camel, you go and get the water, get the food, you travel, you do everything. Why is that? I couldn't say no. The Prophet ﷺ was asking me and I told him the price and he said, agreed, deal, done. Oh, they were really angry, the family. So he can't do nothing. He went to the Prophet ﷺ with his camel and Bilal was there. He says, the Prophet ﷺ, here is the camel, you know. Till the Prophet Jabir brought the camel for sale. Jabir went inside, the Prophet ﷺ gave him double the money, which is price of double good camel, and said to him, keep your camel, this is the gift for you. I was just joking with you. So he gave him the money, and he gave him the camel back to go home. Subhanallah. Jabir, of course, the most famous story about Jabir, everyone should know, it is in the Battle of Al-Khandaq, when the Sahaba were digging the trench just to defend themselves from the, you know, from the pagan. They have to dig a hole, really, to stay behind. And they were stuck in there for 4 weeks. 4 weeks, the whole month under this huge attack, running out of food in Medina. And the Prophet ﷺ carrying rocks and stone with them. When Jabir saw this, he says, wallahi, my heart sank. I can't even go home and eat. And the Prophet ﷺ in the heat and this like that. He rushed home, said to his wife, make some food for the Prophet. Make some food. She says, where from? She said, whatever food you have, just cook. I need. She said, wallahi, we only have this enough meat for two people. Just get the Prophet ﷺ to just invite two. Don't make it, you know, just whisper in his ear, say, come to my house, I got some food for you. So Jabir, and you know, the trench have 1,000 people. Jabir went, whispered in the ear of the Prophet ﷺ, Messenger of Allah, we got some meat in the house. Please come to my house and have some lunch. The Prophet ﷺ removed the dust and stood up and make announcement. Yeah, army, the whole army of Al-Khandaq, we have lunch at Jabir's house. He said to him, you go rush home, tell your wife, don't uncover anything. Just leave everything, the pot's cooking, the dough for the bread, just leave it covered. Let me do it. I'll dish it up. He rushed home, and his wife looks, and she finds an army coming behind him. And she's, you know, she said to him, didn't I tell you? Oh, you're embarrassing us. How are we going to feed them? He says, I told him in his ear. I whispered to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. She said, did he invite? Look at Subhanallah, the believer. He says, yeah, he invited everybody. She said, no problem. He knows what he's doing, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gone inside, and he said to the army, only 10 at a time. Come 10 inside, and he will feed. Wallahi, the narrator says, they have toothpicks picking meat out of their teeth. They go 10, and the next 10. They go 10, and the next 10, and they eat meat. And they say more than 800 people. Eight. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to Jabir, give to your neighbors. Give some to your neighbors. This food is not going to finish. Subhanallah. Wallahi, it's not the quantity. It is the barakah, is the blessing. When Allah put blessing in your time, you can achieve a lot. In your health, in your family, in your money, in your joy, in your peace, in just barakah. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for barakah. And that's why we always say, barakallahu lakuma wa barakah. Yeah, this is the dua for family. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill our life with barakah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us with Jabir and his father in Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raise our rank in the dunya and akhirah. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وجزاكم الله